just take Drow. And yeah. you guys came close to beating them every game,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, actually, like...
It was a very close series.
We were fine against Wings. I mean, we could win those games.
Yeah.
We lost. But at least we gave them a fight. And against Liquid, we just...
Yeah.
Blow up, so I don't know. Draw is okay, and I'm not sure if it's first phase pick. I see it a lot in China, but I think it's really beatable. I don't see it that strong, but same time I see the teams having very good win rate with this hero, so I don't know. Elder Titan is, oh my god, this hero.
He's a problem, huh?
He's a problem.
Yeah.
Also, I see that Liquid and Wings are two teams that playing a lot of bottom this tournament.
Yeah.
Like OG not picking his hero, so it's probably the reason they ban it. So,
not something they really kind of care to go with here. And because Liquid don't have access to the Mirana, they just get what was their next most valuable pick and grabbing up the Shadow Demon one, who's able to easily bail out an ally who's in need. And it could scale greatly throughout the game, almost infinitely with the power of his disruption.
Infinitely?
I don't know. Infinitely, I guess, because, you know, scales as good as the enemy's core scale, you know?
Yeah.
And percentage-based Soul Catcher obviously will scale well. And Purge is always a nice tool to have, so... With all that said, he might be a pretty good hero.
Okay.
So, and everyone's already been praising Mind Control for his Faceless Void play, so he gets a comfort grab.
Yep.
So we'll have to see if OJ plan things a bit differently. This time they find more value in going for the Moon hero sooner, and they'll opt for the Batrider.
Yeah, so both are offlaners picked, and each team taking one support. Nothing crazy. Yet.
We'll settle down.
Still plenty of time for crazy, you know?
Is it not weird at all? I mean... Picking Batrider into Shadow Demon, he's not like your atypical Batrider counter, but Disruption is pretty nice to have to bail someone out from a lasso, I guess.
Yeah. Bat has three other spells as well, I guess, is the kind of argument there. He can farm quite well in the jungle. He can offer a lot of pressure the lane a lot as well, so...
And it can also go any lane, so it's pretty strong. It's people try to counter Batrider with some Venge and Oracles and heroes like this, or maybe some carries like Juggernaut, Lifestealer, but yeah, it's still fine. It can find his ways in the game.
What happened to Naix? Nobody's really played it except you guys played in a couple of games, but no one else has really been picking Lifestealer at all.
He got nerfed, I guess, a lot. Maybe it was enough, but he's still a viewable hero. Like, I saw OD today, and it was super unexpected for me, because I think this hero is super weak right now.
Yeah, and there's some heroes, like, asking about which heroes are, like, strong or too weak, but, like, what heroes do you miss playing in mid that you wish you could play mid again?
I'm fine with anything. Like, Pudge, yeah, obviously, I miss it. Like, it seems like it's pretty hard to play some active heroes right now, and okay. Snowball out of control and stuff like this, because if you look at top teams with, like, OG Liquid, obviously, they pick heroes like... They pick three cores that usually hard to gank or kill. Like, almost every game you see Juggernauts, Timber Souls, Voids, some even Medusas came in. So, basically, if you pick some Elder Titan, and you pick some three cores that are hard to kill, it's like pretty much you're set for the game. You can play carefully, and usually you can defend high ground, and you can take it to a late game.
And your team loves to go for kills too. Like, you guys always ganking, putting pressure early. So,
but still, we're trying to like to pick those kind of heroes also, and see how it goes.
Yeah, still lots of rush with Na'Vi. You still see your Terrorblade and your Lycan can come out. Just go full Divine.
It's an
enjoyable
Divine.
Time. Yeah, it's very enjoyable. And can be a bit disruptive to teams who like to play a bit more conservative. We saw a bit of that when you guys took down Fnatic. Now for Liquid, we're back their way now. Took a lot. Gotta get rid of the Invoker, they got rid of the Tinker. Huskar already, pick number 3. No Dazzle with it, just a Shadow Demon for now. Grant, what kind of tone is Liquid trying to set with that third pick Huskar?
They're pretty much just saying OG. I mean, they've left so many heroes in the pool that are good with Huskar, they can just pick up Huskar here and they can just start running at him early.
What stops OG from going, like, AA right now or something?
Good question.
Hey.
Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, alright.
Alright, well, OG are like, we'll just go it.
Yeah.
Is this bad now? Like, if you're a Huskar, I mean, in a Void, too, it's pretty good against a Void. Like, what do you do now if you're a Huskar? Like, you...
Arbolt
sucks.
You just get
avoid
Oracle in
yeah,
your team.
I think that's what they're gonna do.
Oh, yeah?
Oracle ultimate stops Apparition ultimate, so it might work out. Actually, Liquid picked Huskar against us the same way we picked Elder Titan, Batrider, and I got Huskar. so I guess it's
better. Stats people will love that. That's 2 for 2.
Nah, <it's>...
It should be an Oracle, and yeah.
Apparition is a good pick also against Void here. So.
Are we okay with, you know, that means you're stuck with an Oracle Shadow Demon duo. Is that okay? You know, you don't really have true stun. I don't know what you define as a true stun, but you're just working with, like, Disruption and, you know, casual little Fate's Edict.
But, I mean, Jarek's last game we saw, he solo roamed, got, like, a kill middle, a kill top.
Yeah, he's really good.
They're fine with that.
Maybe we don't pick Oracle without Priestess of Amon. Because 2 games it was Oracle Podem against us. I'm not sure about that. Let's see what we got.
Yeah, I mean, is it? I mean, I know you don't want to pick a Dazzle into
AA. Almost out of reserve time already.
But were they really caught off guard? They're gonna get the Dazzle regardless. I mean, yeah, it's nice. Obviously, Dazzle and Huskar are a match made in heaven with Shadow Demon. You got the heal bomb potential. You know, bail them out with the grave, but. You know, one ice blast in a good spot, then you feel like you're not really contributing a whole lot to the sustain of the team. What do you think, Gods? I mean, going for the Dazzle, is that Liquid saying, well, we have what we want to do, and we don't really care what OG gets?
A bit more presence in lane 2, you can help the Void out with the Dazzle. Like, you can't really, if you have SD Oracle, neither of those heroes can help the offlane out that much. And the Dazzle SD have the Disruption to Shadow Wave combo. So.
Yeah, super combo.
Can OG now, like, what's typically good to just kind of man mode against the Huskar here? I mean, or Axe, so some way to, like, you know, you can help with against the Dazzle, against the Huskar. I know they already have Moon on the bat, but, you know, I don't know if they want to try to integrate some unique core into their game.
Slark maybe is okay.
Slark.
They really like Slark, so.
Haven't seen that much either lately.
Maybe they take a page out FDL and grab the Troll.
A Troll.
That'd be a lot of fun.
It would be. I don't really think that's a hero, but...
What about Weaver? How does Weaver fare against Huskar? Is that okay? I mean, we know the olden days of Weaver AA, and maybe he can, like, take out some of these flimsy little supports in the back lines and dodge Huskar in that kind of a fight.
I think we need some Blade Mail hero. Blade Mail actually counters Huskar so
that's
good.
True.
Like, Axe jumping with Blade Mail. But it is pretty hard to find space. I'm not sure who's gonna play what. So.
Okay.
But maybe any other hero with Blade Mail also good. Seems they don't care. Actually, it's pretty weird to see Dazzle pick into Apparition.
Yeah, that's where it really feels like Liquid are just like, well, we're doing our thing. And I'm not saying they're not giving respect to OG's picks, but it seems like they already had a headstrong game plan in mind, and they're not going to be deterred from it. But Terrorblade with the pickup from OG. I don't know if that means that they're playing on more sidestepping the Huskar and working around his peaking time, because Liquid's lineup is what looks like it's going to be more high tempo, right?
They just didn't ban anything.
Yeah, that got cut down to 0, right?
They banned nothing. Are they really that perplexed? Or are they?
I think they just didn't realize they used all the reserve time.
They spent a lot of time for that Dazzle pick, so. Yeah,
that's making a statement. Or, like you said,
I feel they should have banned the Axe. I still think Axe is
now
really
OG
good
do the no ban also. And
who? Could.
Yeah.
I mean, they might. They only have 4 seconds of reserve time.
Come that on. Would that'd be a good response. I'd no like ban into no ban.
No ban, no ban.
Yeah, do it.
No.
Oh.
Zeus. They get rid of the Zeus.
Tryhards.
Tryhards.
Obviously good against the Terrorblade.
Yeah,
oh,
yes,
they go for the Axe.
That,
okay.
That was pretty obvious. Yeah.
So you get your Blade Mail candidate against the Huskar. You have a good way to stop
I'm really
the Dazzle.
Surprised they didn't ban that.
Wait, basically,
just the black square.
They couldn't find Axe on the thing or something. They caved to the pressure.
TB was a hero who created this 4+1, and basically we needed something more active, and Axe is a hero.
I hope they pick something. They
so Team Liquid now need to pressure and
Timber Sovereign.
OG just need to survive for some time, I guess.
Timber the last pick, able to shred through some media strength heroes like Axe, good against the illusions of Terrorblade. But I don't know, is Timbersoft 5th pick good enough to, you know, for the what be suspect Huskar Dazzle duo into an AA? What do you guys think about the draft and how is game 3 going to go? We can start here nearby me. And
oh, with me.
With Grant.
I don't know, I like OG's draft more. I think the last pick Axe was just super good. They're going to have a lot of pickup on the Huskar, and AA hits one ulti and see ya.
Do you agree, Parker?
I think it's a very good Timbersaw game. The last pick was kind of perfect for Liquid's draft with versing Terrorblade Axe and I think execution's going to be key here. It is Husker's going to have a rough time regardless, but Timbersaw maybe just needs to step it up.
And Dendy, what do you think?
Yeah, Timber is actually pretty good. He cuts down on TB, Axe, and everyone. But as I say, like, Liquid have 3 cores. It's pretty hard to kill, actually. And we have 2 supports who are saves. And actually, those supports are not very passive, because if we run around together, we can make some kills. So Liquid kind of have active early pressure on lanes. And OG, they don't have much disables. And it's pretty hard to... Oh, actually, Elder is the hero that's too strong, so maybe it can create some stuff early game. But overall, it's, I think OG really depends on laning phase right now.
And they kind of catch the smoke out on Jarex.
Liquid smoked in base, and some of them were really slow to leave.
Yeah.
This is some unsure start for Liquid.
AA really needed level 6, and I'm not sure if AA and Elder can create like lots of space for their core heroes early game. So, depends on laning phase a lot. I think Liquid can pressure with those heroes.
Okay. So it might be safe to say for OG, their lane stage is a bit more precious than where Liquid is, if these supports can bulk up some levels a bit and they don't get too put off by the laning aggression that Liquid can bring.
Yeah, did Moon go Iron Talon or Boot? No, neither. Okay. Stick.
That's very unlike Moon. Off of the stick instead, and looks like he'll take his business top. Oh, bottom lane, mind control, eating a couple of pot shots. Is going to be forced to time whack out already. Crit gets hit with the disruption and dances around Jarex a bit.
Both runes, he stole top.
Wow. Both runes going OG.
Wow.
And it looks like Miracle will take his axe indeed to the mid lane here. So
Timber versus Axe. Axe is gonna have a decent time early.
Dendy, you're playing mid lane. Your Axe going against Timber. What's your thought process?
It's actually easy lane for Axe. It's not so hard to stay
with Timber. Yeah, Fly eats a lot of heal damage there because of the disruption set up from Jarex. Keep to the work of the combo. Yeah.
Already down.
But now crit.
I can get more with next disruption.
Metamorphosis is so good at level 1.
6 seconds before it's back up here.
Oh!
OG dish out the ice gloves though, and will be able to get the takedown of Kuro, making it a 1-for-1.
We played around for too long, and A came in with his third spell.
It's a pretty damn good level 1 spell too.
Probably one of the best.
Lots of extra damage, especially with the more you get onto it, but yeah.
It's gonna be hard for them when TB lose form.
Yeah.
So Axe against Timber is actually pretty easy before Timber gets level 6, and if their enemy supports can gank you, like I had a game against Ricky, so Ricky couldn't really do much with Timber to me, but I failed myself, I tanked tower and died like a noob. So.
So modest.
It's you can even like pass the creeps, but here he can't do that because there's Shadow Demon who can TP anytime and they can do some stuff.
Speaking of Shadow Demon, looking to make his move for the Timber. Can they get the heal off? No Tail tries to turn the corner to walk away from this one. It looks like he'll be good for now. And Fly steps in with that new bit of bonus damage and tries to soften up Liquid.
I think any hero way would jump except TB way would kill because TB have too high armor, 11 armor, and
poor man.
Dazzle heal is physical damage.
Yikes.
Ooh.
Do you think it's smart of Liquid to go with the aggro
trialing? Can he get spins? Tries to go for it. Oh! Not going to be getting it. Very far also not going to be enough. And Bata takes the kill.
Wow.
And top lane, Moon!
I was wondering how this top lane was going to be going with the 1v1. And jeez.
Wow.
Matumbo went way too aggressive. He needs few more levels to get his passive. Up.
That is not going to be an easy 1v1 until he does get those levels together, so bit off-putting there. OG take one top as Liquid get that one mid, but the bottom lane is where the real frisky action is happening here.
Frisky action.
Yeah. I like to say frisky action.
Liquid took those risks to put triple lane, hard lane, and leave their Husker alone, but I think it pays off for them because TB not having an easy game, but still it's like 10 creeps for him, so I don't know, I'm not sure.
Yeah, we'll have to see if both teams are going to be content here on keeping this try versus try matchup, or if they're going to try to offer some assistance in either of these other two lanes if one falls too much the other way.
I mean, what's Huskar here for? Like, he doesn't do that great versus like a Blademail Axe or even just TB.
I don't know if it's like any other Huskar game where he's just trying to get an armlet right away and be able to kind of snowball and take advantage of the window before OG's supports get their level 6s and stuff.
That's
but,
a good tempo here for sure.
Oh, hits up the health potion.
Yeah, but for now it looks like he'll be fine.
Yeah, but still Axe having 18 creeps, yeah. He's absolutely fine. He can easily farm.
It looks like Fata's kind of hanging around to make sure he wasn't going to be able to get the easy jungle camp, but Miracle goes for it nonetheless, while Liquid here are working with the side pull. Crit and Fly just kind of have to watch from the outskirts here, and they will commit in with the stop. No Tail moves in, pops out the Metamorphosis, and will be able to zone back Kuro here. And now they have the damage output to kind of take back dominance in this lane. And with that, yeah, it looks like Jarek's taking his business top lane to get a bit of a save here from Matumba Man. He steps back, still has 5 stacks on him here. Can Moon get some more of it? Yes, he can. We'll be able to burn him down. He loses his own life. Jarex will benefit a lot from the XP there, but Moon strikes at Matumba Man once more.
Moon abuse turn around, most speed, and we can just run circles for Huskar, and Huskar can't do a hit. That's pretty cool, because Huskar turnaround is pretty bad.
Yeah.
I think. Actually, Liquid did pretty smart job, because of the way he went. Oh. Fata diving, but he have no second spell.
Yeah, no timber
can't do
change.
Much. Because we went triple lane, hard lane, Axe can't really leap for jungle and put support
now.
There for XP.
Moon, Hog ties up, Fata pulls him back under the tower, straight into a call, and straight into a dunk.
Way too aggressive.
Moon's doing really well this game on the bat. Winning his lane, that rotation there, helping Axe out.
Yeah, his other two games, we didn't really get to see Moon, you know, really shine. He had great farm, but, you know, he ran into some shortcomings when the fights break out, but it looks like Game 3 is looking to really step it up.
It's the Arcane Boots on Moon.
Yeah, he does that a lot.
Yeah, that seems to be a frequent thing for him and his Batrider. Benefiting from, obviously, getting the early Mana Burst and later on can transition to Aether, but look at
barely.
This.
What a catch.
It's a long-range disruption catch here, but hey, how you doing? Dumps him right back, and now Cutter the Shotgun tries to muscle his way with some armor, but not going to be happening. Crit also not going to catch with the stop. Miracle loses his own life in exchange for Jarex. And,
it's still fine exchange for Liquid. Well, not what they expect. Axe actually farms faster in jungle right now, and it's much more safer for him, so Timber can't really do anything to him, and you can put some A in it, but because of triple lane, hard lane, they couldn't do that, but maybe now they can. But actually, they rotate back with Shadow Demon, so...
Yeah, they want to keep making sure that this Terror Blade is...
Yeah, and
not
these two supports, like Elder and Apparition, they stick to Terror Blade because we need to help him out.
Yeah.
And that's why no one can go...
On the bright side for OG, though, they can continue to take advantage of Matumba Man on the other side of the map, and there you see it, they'll take him down.
Just rotate.
So which is more devastating, you feel? Is it Matumba Man keeps, you know, getting taken down the top lane, or is it that this Terror Blade is having a difficult time in the bottom lane?
I think it's worse for Liquid, for sure. Mm-hmm. Like, we need to have good start for Huskar.
Okay, looks like they will be able to take down Fly. So, that's maybe just, you know, OG trying to get Fly towards this middle lane where he can find some solo XP or something, but obviously no easy matchup there. He goes down, and Liquid open up on the bottom lane in the meantime. Softening up that tier 1 a bit. And No Tail just rotated away from the bottom lane entirely, and is still going to take advantage of the top lane where OG have been doing most of their work.
It's a good move to get out of that bottom lane. You're not going to defend it, and you're not farming down there. So just head to your off lane, take farm priority. Batrider doesn't need more right now.
This is so aggressive by both teams.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, don't forget there's a tier 1 tower.
Matumba is triggered.
Yeah, he is.
He's still the... Actually, he's doing the right thing, because from this far behind, farming won't give him anything. He need to do some kills to get back into the game. Or at least to be an assist. Yeah. Yeah, like, to get an assist in the kills.
So Liquid is thirsty for blood right now.
Terror Blade's only level 4, so... Liquid's super fine with that.
Yeah, both these cores are kind of being brought down a serious peg, and are both they're going to be trying to find their own way to recover. Terribly more so any sort of opening lanes to farm in, and as Dendi was saying from Matumba Man, it's taking some heads and trying to get some kills to kind of bring back the farm. Looks like Fatsu's grabbed himself an Invis Rune. He's starting to get some points into Timber Chain, so now has the mobility, and that along with his ultimate, maybe he could set up some kills here on his journey towards a Bloodstone.
Yeah, Axe is still very, very fun this game. We'll have...
Yeah, he's keeping snowballing.
Yep. Almost blink.
Good timing.
How about this AA here? I mean, I'm sure tomes are going to be coming his way, but he needs to get to level 6.
He tries to go mid, and then like Liquid, that's like an easy kill for a Timbersaw and Shadow Demon. Jerix is always roaming.
But you want to get that blink, Ice Blast, Stomp, Spirit. You want the whole shabam here if you're OG.
Yeah, I think, like you say, he takes the Tome of Experience over any of these other heroes, even if they're not level 6 as well.
Roger really, did really good move. They rotated TB top to push.
Oh. Wow. Now you see him, now you don't.
That's the caster curse. You say someone did good move and then they immediately die.
In this rune, it's pretty hard to control if no one checked it out, so, like, nothing.
They're gonna
nothing
go for him.
No tail could do about it.
He's so close to blink, it's like, this better go well.
And there's no way they
can
really
run
kill
in
him here.
Nah, it's
so they rotated TB top to push tower, and at the same time, they left Elder to get XP bottom and AA to get XP mid, and that's what we need. We need levels pretty hard, so now Elder level 6, AA is also close, I guess.
Getting there.
That's the blink now in the hands of your Axe. Fly gets a deep ward here, so now they have the blink.
Opa.
Let's see if they can put some use to it. Let's see some dunks. Who's going to be the first target? Oh, they've spotted Kuro going for the ward here.
Dunk the chicken.
Oh.
Okay, blink dagger spotted. Need some TP bottom.
So they use the smoke for that, and they show the blink dagger.
The Tumble Man is running. They know that they have probably made a rotation and they do not want to get caught on the bad side of it.
Everything's scouted.
That's not good for OG. That's not the ideal blink debut they were hoping for to be spotted out. They lose their ward top lane. They try to rotate elsewhere. That also becomes no excitement there. Miracle's still thirsty though. Trying to stock out this mid lane, but might have to be wait a bit. There he goes. Okay, jumps in for Jerix.
Jerix almost got him.
Yeah, he was mid-cast for that.
But without creeps nearby, no extra spin, so he'll get off the disruption, and he's committed now. Pops out the purge, soul catcher and everything. Heal from Kuro, and Miracle will go down. Might have been overambitious trying to get that kill, but at least they might get a follow-up here. Moon grabs up Mind Control, pulls him back, and will be able to finish it off. Turns into a 1-for-1, and that secures Moon his blink dagger.
There was only machine and range creep, I think, so...
Yeah.
He needed really good RNG to kill.
Yeah.
So it was pretty... I'm not sure about that jump. Like, he needed one more hero for help, I guess.
Just wait for Moon, I think.
It was a 9k jump.
It slows your snowball down a lot when that first blink gank
fails,
too.
Oh, he's still winning some time for TB, so it's
pretty
nice. Anyway.
Nice. Shadow Demon.
Juked.
Easy. Wow. They still have Chrono up, too, so...
Okay, Miracle is back, jumps in, tries to go for Jerix. So there's a counter Chrono there. Earth Splitter was already on the mark. Moon's caught inside, eating a lot of damage from Kuro on the outskirts here. There's going to be the follow-up dunk. The first go down will be Jerix, looking for Mind Control. Gets healed up, though, nicely from Kuro. Terrorblade puts his focus onto him, while on the other side they look to pursue, and they'll get the finish, taking out Mind Control. They also get Matumba Man, and it looks like Kuro will barely be able to live because of the help of the Shallow Grave. Turns into a 3-for-1 trade, and Fata will also be waltzing out from that one. Bit of an awkward split. Ults on top of each other. The Earth Splitter, though, right down the middle.
Yeah, they're splittering, and then the Heal Bomb from Dazzle melted them.
OG taking pretty good lead here.
And with this, they'll hope to try to maybe make an objective follow-up on at least this tier 1.
It's getting so hard for Liquid right now because A got 6, Elder got 6. It's pretty hard to fight him. Yeah, but try to have dagger and stuff.
And Hasker has not had much farm this game, so he's just always trying to catch up.
Just got that armlet, but you gotta be, you know, careful of the ice blast in your armlet.
No, there is no Chrono for Liquid, so we can't really defend this tower.
Just gonna zone him out.
Force them back, but Liquid are rotating in here. First one in is Fata, well up and above. Jerix caught out from Miracle as he makes the committed jump. Fata wants to help out. Moon already makes his move. Also, an ult for Jerix here as he uses the lasso, but ends up losing his own life. Liquid are here, they will defend. Doesn't matter if they don't have a Chrono, they make it work.
Yeah, TP form went down.
Yeah, they had no damage. Didn't use Ice Blast, maybe.
They used but just to scout, I guess.
Yeah, it didn't really connect with anyone.
Oh yeah, earlier in the tower.
He should have it now though, or just about up. If OG do decide they want to defend this tier 1, Fly is waiting on the high ground to drop it right on Matamaman here. If
no
possible,
meta,
but...
no bad. That last teamfight that OG won, I think Bat did almost more damage than anyone else on the team.
Nope. Looks like they're good though, and they'll decide to pull off in the meantime here. And
it's actually so fun to watch. It's going back and forth.
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay, crit.
Uh-oh.
OG looking to scout out, but you'll see mind control jump in. Crit's going to be forced to kind of head out the other way. And OG also going to be coming in from behind here. If Liquid do pursue, is Crit going to bait them into an awkward position, or are they going to get the jump on for him? Tries to go for the stomp, but gets canceled from the chrono. He goes down, and that's going to be the first stand of this fight as Liquid take out the support here, but OG not looking to chase yet.
They have Metamorph again, so if they can get catches...
It's hard though, you know, I gotta get the right catch to pull back and land up a nice blast here, but... OG will just have to let that one go. Just Crit who kinda tanks that full gank.
Timber could have like a 16 minute Bloodstone, that's good. Especially for that lane.
At this stage, it's kinda, it's a lot of ways faster than the carry.
Yeah.
He's the one who's gonna scale.
Miracle.
No spin. There we go.
Are you guys going to curse down Fata for this one? It looks like it could happen here. Call, lasso, pullback. Jarek's nearby to save him if necessary. Still holds on to it and might not even be necessary. Fata lives on. Tries to make a jump there, but there is a sidestep blink. That'll be the end of it. A committed lasso leads to no kill. A bit unfortunate for OG and good hold for Liquid.
Yeah, Jarek's is the only one like showing himself half the time, so they keep trying to go on him, but the Dazzle's always behind him.
OG supports are a little bit poor right now. I don't know. They can't find a ways to get money, I guess. It's like... strange.
Hey, super poor.
Oh.
Yeah, he's got levels, but has yet to, like, land an ice blast or make any sort of team impact to try to get assist gold, if anything, at all. Or some sort of fight participation. It's a hard life as an AA.
Feels like
I guess.
Liquid loves this because Matoma Man's been farming now, and the Axe and the Batrider have just been running together, and they haven't even gotten kills doing that.
Yeah, this is like their stride. I mean, they got their blinks, they got their setups. This is when OG should be really raking in the kills. But Liquid not making it easy at all. Always have some sort of response team nearby or a way to kind of counter back to OG. And it's kind of turned into a bit of an awkward spot for OG here where they continue to like float around this mid lane while no one's really farming top. And, you know, Matumbo Man just gets a free lane to continue farming and farming.
Looks like Liquid is just farming more right now. Yeah. Like Matumbo already recovered and Timber is defending tower pretty well with Shadow Demon.
Yeah, the only farm hero for OG is, you know, just kind of this no-tailed Terrorblade, and his eyes are set on this tier 1 mid lane. So they just continue to hurtle around him a bit. Well, Liquid farms him the rest of this map.
No Dragonlance Terrorblade.
It's a scary rune for Axe to have for this push, though.
Yeah.
You think you have vision because it's daytime, but an Invis Axe will suddenly pop out. Liquid are playing positioning very well.
Yep. And we'll see. I wonder if they're waiting to see if anyone from Liquid will move forward here. It looks like actually OG are pulling out to go for Matumbo Man in the bottom lane. Matumbo Man spotted Crit. He's trying to get the grab for him. Can he finish him off? Moon will first tie him up, and it looks like they will be able to take down the Huskar. Cute little pick right there on the bottom where Matumbo Man is farming, but the rest of Liquid looking to make their own approach. I'm sure they have Chrono up and ready to go here. Will mind control. Be able to see the target. He's eating a lot of damage from the Metamorphosis. We'll be able to time walk off said damage. And all the meanwhile, it looks like Fata has made a deep dive to be able to finish off that Crit Elder Titan. Jarek's very low, barely saved up from the Shallow Grave, gets a heal, and is able to survive here. OG on the way out, no tail very low, Chakram sidestep. Meanwhile, Miracle going to be able to get the dunk finish.
Sunder.
Takes out Jarek's. Can he Sunder up? Yes, he can. Fata going to be very low on that one. Tries to run away as Moon makes chase. Mind Control slows him down with a Chrono as he's right in the midst to get up. Miracle will finish him off. No tail though, with his new life, moves in and hopes that OG can clear up the rest of the Liquid remains here. Kuro, poor little Dazzle caught in the river, makes him sweat for it, tries to get Moon down, but Moon will be able to make it away. Kuro in the back end of his shallow grave is going to be chomped down from no tail.
We don't know if you want to fight here.
Huskar's back now.
Timber's back too, he has Bloodstone.
Oh, this is not good for OG. It looks like Liquid could end up with the last laugh, committed dive in. We'll help get the finish on Moon and the double kill from Matoma Man. Wow. He's able to get the follow-up. Vata's here now too. And suddenly we're back the other way as OG end up losing four. They did lose crit, so technically it was a five-man wipe on the side of OG. And that will allow Liquid to be able to move into the Roche pit here.
It's still back and forth.
Yeah. Just the fight lingering and going on so loud allowed Liquid to kind of come in for round number two.
Yeah, help Timur saw that Bloodstone, he came back super quick.
Yeah, and that tier 1 in the bottom lane made it so easy to be able to just rotate down there and be a part of the fight again. And now we're going to see a free Roche. Or Liquid goes right into the pocket of Matoma Man. Got him!
Okay,
free Roche for Aegis.
Very nice. Meanwhile, crit bottom needs to be a bit careful here. Been a tough game for Zelda Titan, 0-3, but he's there for the natural order and stomps that up. Do you think with that fight, with Liquid taking the Roche, but they did end up losing their Aegis right away, are we again back to square one here, or is that enough of an advantage for Liquid to kind of, you know, be up and ahead and pressure be on OG now to get something done? And I mean, I say that and they're smoking, so I imagine they might feel that way.
You know, a lot of OG's strength right now is just having these two strong blink initiations where you've got catch followed up by an ice blast, start a fight off with a kill. And then if the fight sustains itself, if TP's there with Metamorph, you have DPS still. But I don't think OG want to just try and play a farm-only type game with the double blink daggers.
What's No-Tail going? He has a Yasha, but he has another Blade of Alacrity.
Diffusal Blade?
Diffusal? Is that...
Early Diffusal.
Is that good?
I'm not sure.
I don't know if it is or not. Yeah, it's weird.
So it's a lot on Team Shouders right now. Actually, Roshan got nerfed so many times, like, but it's it doesn't give you so much XP now, and doesn't give you so much gold, but it gives you Aegis, and it's pretty important to have it, I guess.
And so, they lost it already.
Yeah.
OG have been kind of some of them that parked in this top lane is. Miracle's been farming with Fly in the lane to soak up the solo XP, but they could be cut off from behind here. Looking to sweep in is Matoma Man and company.
Oh.
They're totally surrounded here.
Oh,
Ryze goes for the blink. Matoma Man goes for his own leap, and that will lead into the... I like that. Mind Control sidestepping the Ice Blast, but he got the Chrono down. They're going to get the kill on Miracle. Looks like Fly has made it away, but still another notch in the belt of Liquid on that one.
Get his Bloodstone charges back.
Mm-hmm. And this was, as a response, OG will grab the tier 1 in the bottom lane.
They can even pressure the tier 2 if they see Liquid keep going top. Nah, Liquid's already having to be forced back.
And more tomes now for Fly, so he can continue to ramp up the XP and get that Ice Blast online. We have yet to see kind of like the big setup from OG, if that's what they were hoping for with this kind of lineup. You know, jump in with Axe, get everyone together, big Ice Blast, clean up.
Trying to fight, if they can catch someone. They know Timber's still TP bottom.
Okay, lead committed. Moon made it away, so it looks like that will be the end of it. But Liquid continue to farm up, and you can see the net worth begin to ramp up even more so now as it pushes past 5k. OG get a gem though, and can kind of take the vision map on them back on the map here. And it looks like it's going to be like a pipe game here for this Timber. Mm. Obviously helps against the crippling magic damage that OG can put out, whether it's the, you know, Ice Blast itself. They're ready.
Guess we'll see what this Diffusal's for. He's got it.
Jump in. Miracle catches two. Ice Blast will be there with the stomp on top. Lasso pullback into takedown of Jerix here. Kuro stays alive, but not for long as they'll dunk down that shallow grave. Meanwhile, Matoma Man is going to be able to get the finish. It looks like Fly Fata jumps right on through and be able to take out Crit. But No-Tail looking to man up here as Mind Control makes it back away. They change course. Looking to go for Matoma Man. He gets dunked, but Miracle loses his own life right on the back end of that one. But Fata, the janitor, cleaning up, doing work, putting the most out of this arcane. It's going to be Moon, the last survivor, as he makes it back to the base. Another fight going the way of Liquid here.
Three ults by Axe.
Some fights. Arcane Rune.
Timber.
Yeah, actually this Arcane Rune.
The cooldowns on all his spells. I couldn't believe how much he was throwing out spells there, and then I'm like, okay, he's glowing pink.
Wow.
That rune wins them that fight.
Man, just look how much we're farmed.
Timber is getting so big.
Yeah, he is... feeling like he's beginning miles above the rest. Matoma in the closest target, and then you get to Moon, and then the Terror Blade. So, not looking good for OG here with how things are developing in the economy game.
Yeah, just feels like they're just farming slowly, and it's like he said, the 4 protect one on Terror Blade, and he just doesn't have that much, just the Diffusal and Yasha.
OG will try to at least scrap together some support takedowns here. They spot out Jerix, and he gets completely dumpstered on. So easy little Shadow Demon takedown. Kuro's here now with Fata, and it looks like OG will have to reevaluate this. Fata definitely adds a new force, and it looks like his pipe is just about done too. So his team will definitely benefit by rallying around him. So do you think it's just at this point forward, Liquid can kind of go, or do they continue to have to play around like their Chronosphere and make sure everything's up?
I guess we're pretty fine. Later goals, they still have three cores to play around. They have Weave to increase the power of them.
Aether on bat.
And they also probably look at OG and think they're going to keep trying to fight us. Like, you get Diffusal, some of those items to me, it's really good efficient early game stats, but if you think it's going to go late game, you don't want to buy a Diffusal.
It seems like we feel we need to do something now. Mm. Maybe we are right. It's hard to say what's going on. At draft stage, I thought that if Liquid don't pressure, it's going to be really hard for them to fight. And this Dazzle pick was pretty weird for me, but now, as I'm looking forward, it's working out for them. But it's still an even game, so...
Yeah, I mean, when Liquid have to get to that point when they want to maybe start breaching into OG's base, it doesn't look like it'll be the easiest task. OG do have a lot to work with to kind of make sure Liquid don't take over too much if it's a 5v5, at least a push. So I don't know if that means Liquid are going to have to hope for any sort of pickoff to follow it up first. We'll see. Oh, Solar Crest now done on your Dazzle too, so...
Oh boy, and he's just going in.
Fata, no respect for this Miracle Axe, yeah. The Mech Warrior here. Asserting dominance.
That's it. It's gonna take middle tower, looks like. Blue and orange are
it's
in the other,
push time.
Other team's jungle.
Come on, OG, we'll have to see if any defense is in order for them, or if it's in their best interest to even defend this tier 2. This is with AA at the top lane, probably lining up a huge ice blast shot from behind. I think he sent it out right now. The Moon, last so grab pullback. Tom gonna help out from the disruption. Meanwhile, the Miracle surrounded by two. The ice blast is there. Connects on mind control. He's gonna be forced back. But Fata, happy to kind of truck on forward.
Shadow,
hey, kill
they got the Void.
Is it going to be enough here? Fata now deciding to withdraw. Liquid don't like the way this is going.
Oh, defuse him.
Oh!
The bump is not going to be there. The chain goes off. Fata makes it back and away, and it looks like it could be a 2-for-1. The first fight in a while that OG are going to be the successors.
This is really just back and forth. Ooh, look at that Siege unit. One more hit. Got it.
Two cores for one.
Yep.
Good fight for OG. Nicely set up. Miracle catch the two. Ice Blast was there. And it'll allow No-Till to kind of clean up the pieces. What do we got? What are these? Yules? Yules and a Manta. Yules.
Yeah, TB Yules.
Yeah. Well, I saw Yules' recipe. Someone got a Yule.
Yeah, then the us casters, we're not very clever at Dota. Yeah,
what?
Be nice
I'm
to
joking.
Us.
Yeah, you're dumb, Dakota.
I was saying all of us.
No,
is the players here not very clever also?
Where's Manta, as I mentioned, all online now. Let's see if OG can make the most of what they got for this, because Liquid's still in a pretty good spot overall.
Liquid just can't really lose a fight by their base, and they're fine with anything, really.
What about as the game progresses here? I mean, we know it's a 4-1, it's just a Terror Blade alone, but do Liquid have the scaling potential to match up against that? I mean, Fata seems to be pretty nice on his Timbersaw, and, you know, Huskar is obviously a bit questionable in the late game.
Yeah, I think as long as Axe keeps getting items, they're fine.
This lineup is pretty strong, like both lineups are pretty strong late game. Supports are late game oriented and from both sides, and cores are the same way. Like, we both are, like, every core is good in late game, same.
Po culling still, trying to get a little more extra.
Gonna have to wait a bit there, Liquid. It looks like we got about another minute, or maybe they're just looking to go for a smoke inside the pit. Nonetheless, BKB now done on their precious Huskar. And we'll see if it's go time now for Liquid.
Wait, Mail. You.
Yep.
Yeah, it was last night.
That was the smoke. Magical item here.
Well, I see him.
But Liquid smoke up. They go in. Are OG going to find a way to kind of capitalize on this Liquid smoke? Are they looking to dodge it altogether?
Roche.
You don't want to fight now with Ice.
Yeah,
they
open Roche.
Yeah, that's not good. So they might have to quickly pull off.
Ooh, and Liquid know that we're trying to get someone.
We saw that spirit.
Yeah. Just get over here! He's like, he's just muscling his way through. He's like, I'll take anyone at this point.
Yes.
He's hasted.
Uh-oh.
Ah, there you are. Crit's gotta go. TV,
Oh, cheater.
No easy kills on Crit for this one.
Three to go back bottom, defend that tower, and then they know Roche is gonna be up.
So?
Oh.
Is Ice Bus? You can't kill with Ice Bus, can you?
Jarek spots out Moon. Moon says, see ya. Doesn't want any part of it.
Bottom lane, they're going for the kill, I think.
Ice Blast set up on the Matama Man here. Miracle gets there with the call. That's quick and easy.
Cure damage spin. Avoid Crota, though. Right.
Oh, he goes for it.
Here comes his team. He has a lot of damage.
One for one.
Actually, the problem that I can see in late game with OG having only one physical damage guy. It's Turbo 8. Maybe it's enough because it's crazy hero with physical damage, but it's still Weave around. We're gonna have Kuras, Vladimir's, maybe some Greaves and stuff like this.
Shivas or something on the
Solo Crest.
Already Shiva on Timber.
Yeah. So.
So maybe it's gonna be the only problem for him. I'm not sure.
ET refresher.
Still, ET cuts armor off. But it's only natural armor, so.
Yeah, Liquid have the time to farm and to kind of make up for the lack of armor but through their items, as you mentioned. So, as time goes on, their fortitude is going to be that much stronger against any sort of late game physical abilities that OG can pull out. So
it was pretty run at each other for the first 25 minutes, and it just slowed down.
Do you think that's just a... That's just the result of like where their drafts are, and it is, or is it because it's a game number 3 elimination match that obviously these teams are going to be taking things a bit more passive? Do you think it's more so one or the other?
I think game 3s always are a little... Elimination games are always a little more passive-ish, but I think Liquid just doesn't want to lose a fight against a Terrorblade with Manta style up. You just lose your base instantly, so they're playing a little more careful.
It's also the nature of the way OG's played it out, where they're split pushing a bit more, so Liquid's being constantly forced to push our lanes, which is gonna not really promote a game where there's lots of fighting going on.
Yeah, they're running around a lot, but...
You've gotta respect the TP split push now, like... 10, 15, 20 minutes in, he's not gonna threaten your high ground, now he really does.
Yeah, a lot of the focus now, though, is around this spawned Roche.
BKB.
Alright.
But you got one side, OG, who have an Ice Blast in that nice choke point. I mean, a certain EG team, I think, won with the big Ice Blast in the Roche pit.
Oh, indeed.
And they also have the Elder Titan Spirit, and Batrider. OG have a lot of ways to kind of, you know, counter Roche play here, so Liquid are probably going to be more on trying to get a kill before they can move in and get it.
Batrider helps a little bit against Timber in teamfights because of turn rate. Timber really cares about it in teamfights. Else he would probably cut everyone so hard right now. Fada doing really great job at snowballing.
Yeah.
Out of control.
A lot of people used to label Fada for a lot of his Puck, DK, especially Razor and Viper. Filthy heroes there, but he's definitely been pulling out a lot of stuff throughout this tournament and some recent play. Vokers, Timbers.
Yeah, Miranda was like a new hero that Liquid started to pick, I guess, at this tournament. We didn't pick it at Manila, if I'm not wrong.
Oh, we got fall off, but...
But the chain was also there, so Fata's pulled back a bit. There's the Ice Blast. Oh, does connect. Fata could be going down, will go down. The dunk will connect. Meanwhile, Mind Control gets the jump on for Moon. It's offlaner on offlaner here, but Moon says I've had enough.
Oh.
Goes back and away. But someone is going to be forced back, and Dog Rave will keep him alive here, but only for a little bit. So it looks like the dunk is waiting in the pocket. not even necessary. Sunder, but no tail, still very, very low, will end up getting dropped. Miracle picks up where he left off. They will lose no tail, but they're going to wipe out the rest here.
Dang, he got the jam.
Fast fingers.
That was nice.
Unfortunately, yeah, terribly, couldn't find a good Sunder target.
So crazy. But it was so nicely done by OG, actually.
Yeah, they take down, and they take down four and take down a lot of those Bloodstone charges.
And usually it's like Timber is the last hero you want to jump at, but this A ulti, hitting one.
Yeah, you'll take who can get under that big blast there.
Yeah. Wow.
And we'll check out a replay of that matchup and how OG kind of set the stage. They see Fada farming in the mid, the jump call. Knows that the Ice Blast will be able to connect from close range, hits him there with the help of that stun, and eventually they will be able to dunk him
down. Yeah, we were so close of not killing Timber here. So close.
Mm-hmm.
Everything worked so perfectly for him. Elder Stomp.
Oh! Elder we got dying. Crit in trouble. Gets hit with a Chakram here. Gets the stomp off, but does going down. My. Miracle gets the jump call, tries to pull them back, but it could end up pulling him into his own demise here if not careful. Off the blade mill, gets him with time dilation. Moon set all the way and up and into the base if you'd like. Mind control gets him under the tower. They bump it back further. Time walk will get off though, and he'll get all that life back. But he can't seem to be making it too much further. Moon's got the sticky icky on him, and he's just going to try to walk it out and away. But he doesn't have too far to run. There's the dunk killing spree now for Miracle as they exchange the light of crit for the faceless void. Sticky icky.
That reflection illusion from Void hitting himself actually did so much damage to him, to Diffusal Void.
Yeah, that's a good point. Good job, Grant.
Thank you.
Not that you care for my approval. But OG just breathing new life here when it felt like Liquid are just slowly kind of accumulating a lot of farm for themselves and getting the better of the map. Now you see OG going for pick after pick here. And as you can see, they're almost getting another one. Jarek's able to just inch himself out from trouble.
Last is back up already.
And Moon takes to the skies. I think they might be able to have a vision from Atomaman, pulling them all the way back.
Oh.
Fata goes in. If a good Ice Blast connects, it could be trouble. It will connect even through the PKP of Atomaman. And that means that with him jumping in, Miracle will be able to finish him off. Now Dominating looks to go for the follow-up kill. We'll get it onto Kuro. Double kill for him. And now they want Jarex. Can they get that one? Yes, they can. Make it a triple for the 9k player. And now Mind Control. Chrono going to be out for Moon. Has to change course. We're going to go for Miracle. Can we get four? Not going to be happening. He gets bursted low. Might have to sidestep here. Fly will go down. Buyback committed from Fata as he TPs for the tier 2. Moon is going to be on the way out. No Tail looking to do the same. And Force Liquid to really spend their money to no avail. But they will end up catching up. They take Liquid down.
Oh my.
And it looks like the rest of OG are just going to try to run their ass away. Oh, swing in the midst of the Timber Chain. And Crit might be making it away.
He's trucking.
So unlucky with Timber Chain. Sometimes when I play Timber, I'm hooking with those things. I feel like a push. I miss.
Can roll play punch.
I think that was a mistype.
Nope, the game's over.
The game's over.
We don't allow that this summit. Once you say good game, it's over.
Yeah, you're done. There's no fake good games.
But good for OG. And with two back-to-back takedowns.
Yeah, was it Fati did before? Someone did before. In the middle of a team fight, right? And immediately, like, four of the players, like, ulted, like, oh, sorry. That was the major.
Yep, that was definitely Fati.
Valve don't mess around with their rules.
Oh, they're going in on the back.
Oh, he gets Jarek's here.
Nice, heals.
But they surround him. There's going to be the Ice Blast. Does very catch low on the Kuro, but not ideal for OG. And they might be forced to kind of get back and away here, but Liquid happy to make chase. Where,
but he's coming.
Slowly.
Vroom, vroom, vroom.
He's machining his way all the way through. We'll come in with a blink now. He wants crit. Can he get him? Chains on forward. He's going pretty damn ham
here.
There's
no buyback, too. He needs to be careful.
Moon got him. And pulls him back. No Ice Blast, though. Yeah. Vortex with maybe some cold feet. No, that's not happening. He looks for fly, crushes up the Iceman.
Oh. Perhaps he has Ice Blast now. Perhaps miscommunication. They didn't fight around it.
Yep.
Miracle trying to catch anyone from Liquid who's trailing behind. The Tumbleman happy to commit the dunk here. Miracle pops the blade mail though. Gets the call off. And that could lock him in place. Does Miracle have enough firepower though? It does not look like it. He'll end up going down. Chrono out committed for mind control, locks out No-Tail, who's in Metamorphosis, pops out the illusions here, and he tries to dish out the damage. Miracle buyback. Round number two as he jumps in. Gets Fata. Still no fly though, no ice blast for OG.
Oh, he got the Sunder.
Gets the Sunder off. Jerix will be cleaned up here on the back end.
All his TB illusions. So strong.
This is an army of darkness right here from OG. Matumba Man though. Okay, now comes out the goo. With that, he'll try to turn and fight. Move with another lasso, gets the pullback. Mind control's gonna be going down. There's the ice blast. It goes right through Matumba Man, who jumps right through it all. So that means he'll be going down. Mind control also dishes out a buyback. Goes to the tier two in the bottom lane, trying to make a reappearance into this fight. It looks like Liquid want to stay and fight. Otherwise, that is a buyback for Nutton here.
Uh-oh, full HP.
Oh, buyback.
Whoa! Miracle gonna be able to avoid that one. This is turning a bit awkward for Liquid. Can they get something out of it? Nice quick blink from Moon.
So close these fights. And they're 3v4 actually, and
those fights are so chaotic, but it's so hard to like watch if ultimates are up or down, what's happening and so on. I think it's so hard for players.
It's hard to
also
watch, but I mean it's even like you say, even harder to play, I imagine. Like how do you communicate when you're in those situations, like what to do?
It's like those situations happens when one pulls Timber and there is no way ulti to fall and he can't say it down.
How many buybacks were used there? Definitely, you know, the Miracle
mind
buyback,
control.
Mind Control buyback.
Well, yeah.
That was a hard committed fight from both sides. Both of them feeling a lot of value if one was stable to really come out on top.
Either team got another pickoff, they could just go to Roshan. It's so big right now. I think Jags is almost up on A now, but
Opa.
Trouble.
Alright. Chrono for Moon, time dilation, and steps out before the ice blast comes in. So
bam, an ult. Bam, bam, bam,
turn
bam,
it down.
Bam.
Okay.
There's an ult for you and an ult for me. No, Liquid one more. They want to finish off Moon here. Yules will slow down mind control and
out of mana.
Look at that. He's not having any of that. Fata to pull off. Fata steps in. There's a bit of a hot mess here. OG split all over the place. Matumba Man jumps right in, finishes off crit. Crit buys back right away. Liquid don't
re-engage.
Like that.
Everyone's quite low though on the Radiant side. Yeah. A couple heroes are.
This game is like constant fighting for
that's the war,
last 15 minutes at the same place.
Some good Dota.
So does Lotus Orb work on Husker's ult? It just
they dump at each other in midair.
Boom.
Dude, I don't know.
I hope we get to see it.
I hope we get to see it.
Yeah, and I wonder if you cast it on yourself as he's flying in, if it still triggers or not. This will be interesting to see.
The world. His farm really dropped off the Huskars, though. Just armlet, BKB, Helm of the Dominator.
Yeah, he was dying most fights, too, which is rough for him.
Okay. OG, smoke. And they draw out that they want to wrap all the way around from the right-hand side, hoping to maybe catch out Liquid in a bit of a flank here.
Oh,
gotta catch these supports.
Gotta catch the supports. Pokemon, go! Jump in, Moon gets the grab, pullback, ice blast there. Jerix annihilated, first one taken out. Meanwhile, a response, Chrono locks OG in place. No-Tail though, BK beat up, metamorphed up. Now looks to right click, he focuses on the Fata here. Fata though, and as Eddie mentioned, hard to work through the turn rate with that Moon stickiness coming out. Swap back Sunder, No-Tail still holds strong, but Tumman, look at the man up right now, and they slice him down. Oh, hard with fight here. Last one to survive from Liquid though is this man, Fata. And it looks like OG will be able to get the better end. Gem on the deck.
What a crazy fight.
What even happened?
My goodness. Like a seven-man chrono, everyone's just inside of it, no one knows what's gonna happen after.
It's just crazy. It's like one of those chaotic chronos, just like, hold on, I just want to see what's happening in this fight, stop please. Jumps in.
This Timbersaw, they just don't, he's doing so much work, they're not really dealing with him. Trying to save him till the end.
He's pretty hard hero to deal with.
Yeah. You said, the goo's like the best thing they have, just make it so he can't run around, but
and we will check out a replay to see, because I don't know what the hell happened there. And we'll get another look and see. Moon started things off. Got the pullback for Kuro. Ice Blast not that great, but as you can see, a Chrono pretty much catches everyone. The Chakram just rips through crit during that the whole time.
Oh, Miracle gets stuck on the high ground.
Yeah, that's a bit unfortunate for them, and that leaves No-Tail kind of to defend himself. Gets off a huge Sunder, but as you can see, without Miracle, really able to participate till he's able to blink back in. But Tom Man was able to do enough work and helped get the finish on No-Tail.
Oh.
Thoughts is back. He wants Miracle. Miracle. Blade mails up. Tries to avoid him. We'll make it away. A lot of brutes in this one.
It was pretty hard to position oneself for G in that fight. So everyone got caught in Chrono. I think Elder didn't cast his ultimate in that fight. So it was pretty tough. I'm not sure what would happen if Elder would get his ulti off.
Yeah, if that hits someone like Timbersaw, they can actually bring him down. It's possible to kill him if they get the catch with the AA ultimate and the ET ultimate. Uh-oh.
Is he gonna see the Ice Blast coming? Nope.
He got bashed.
Our OG going to dive in for it. Oh, the armlets. Get it careful.
Was AA Axiom? I know he was like a few hundred gold short on the AA.
Still.
Tumba is crazy. Look, he's going for Roshan.
Still.
You know, Ice Blast is on cooldown now. Knows he doesn't need to worry about it, but does he need to worry about the rest of OG? Mind Control is waiting with Chrono in the pocket just in case OG makes a jump here. Crit stomps with a starts with a stomp.
I didn't think they saw Mind Control. Oh, he gets down.
Gets down anyways, finds a Chrono target on the other side, looking to go for Moon, who is trying to set up some sort of counter Roche play. Not going to be happening, plus that's a gem on the deck.
That's
very good words by Dire. I saw him there.
Well, his plot is going in.
And now with that, and with Moon out of the picture, Liquid have advantage in numbers and in Aegis, so...
Yeah, it's so important to have everyone there at this minute, because everyone, like, every hero matters at this point of the game.
This is an Axe Ice Blast, but it looks like it may only catch Mind Control.
It can't contest now, it's shut down.
No-Tail gets perched here. A creepy little Jerix on the outskirts. He's going to force it to a BKB. He immediately sunders Fanta, says thanks for the life.
Opa, Jerix.
It's a bit awkward here. It looks like Jerix, for going for the down the backplate, could pay with his life. Gets a blink out. Very nice from Jerix. And they'll end up finishing off that Roche. Liquid end up creating the space and snag up the token.
One hero in the entire game with buyback. It really speaks how tense and close things are right now.
Yep.
Very good for Liquid now. They can take the stages and kind of slow things down.
They're waiting
if
for
they
the
want.
Ice Blast. I think he pinged it out.
You can't, even if it
way
hits,
off.
I don't think they can't kill him even if it hits.
If it was like 5 creeps, maybe, but probably not, though.
3k HP almost.
Yeah.
No-Tail's running in.
Well, I guess the Ice Blast means he's
and so is Bat now.
Bat, you can kill him.
Yeah, he traveled in. So with 3 of them here, it could be enough. And it looks like it will be no close like
much
number.
Hey.
I am a machine! God damn, this guy is tough. Kill that man! They'll get him now. Timber is not easy, though.
He's dead for 60 seconds. He's going to have to buy back.
Nice pick. And it also means Liquid on
it was
pushing.
So close to the base, but...
That's why
unfortunately.
Some unexpected rotation from OG. It's the first time there's been any action in this top lane. I think Liquid were just so much in the mindset that everything was around Roche.
Mind Control jump in. Proto on for crit. Gets No-Tail as well, but... They focus and try to get the old Titan down, but it's not going to be enough. He gets a Lotus and he's able to step away, and No-Tail says I'll just BKB and TP out.
No Wasso, no A ulti.
No Metamorph is also about to wear off, so it's probably a good time to get the hell out of there.
He supports though.
I think Timber needs some Hex here.
Yeah, how many times have we seen people just kind of barely able to make it away from him?
Alright. Good moves by OG, kind of even out the Roche advantage Liquid
this
had.
Such a back and forth game.
That is. Look at that. Never been higher than 5,000.
Oh, Aghanim's. He just got it, I guess, right?
Yeah, he had it for
last.
Yeah, one blast in the pit, but it did miss, pretty much, so... He hasn't been able to connect with a huge...
That's pretty strong.
Yeah.
He's also close to 16.
It lasts forever, it feels like.
This game is so equal. Those teams are playing really good.
Is he just going MKB? Just damage?
Probably there's Solar Crest.
Yeah,
there's
Solar Crest, yeah.
It's definitely worth it. And Daedalus is still good, but...
But MKB, and he gets a Halberd too. Not gonna be happy when he sees that MKB come out, but nonetheless, Liquid are here, and they're gonna make a move for the tier 2. We'll see what OG's move will be.
They're gonna have 15 till Metamorph, so probably defend high ground, counter push bottom. Try and see if you can force Liquid back first, but...
It looked like Miracle just TP'd bottom lane, though, to join the rest of his team, so I'm not too sure. So Liquid are actually gonna be...
Liquid don't push that fast, so if there's like a threat of split push at bottom lane, they almost have to defend even when they have Aegis.
Yep. And with that, they draw Liquid away. And we'll try to probably continue to stall things out while Liquid do have that extra life. More maneuverability coming out from OG here. Elder Titan will help avoid the trouble of this. Avoid it getting away from this Huskar and obviously the chase of the Timbersaw.
We see him ping out the Ancients they want to go for, but no one's there.
MKB already done. I thought he just got that Demon Edge. Jesus. Still though pales when you look at Fata. 26k of net worth for him.
Oh. Oh, both use scans right away.
Is this smoke from Liquid?
Was that their scan they just used at the top
lane
there?
They both used scans, yeah. Okay. I don't know who used whose, but...
I thought they would have caught Miracle if that was Liquid scan, but... He's still there. Oh! Jump right for him, they see him. He tries to go for the force TP.
What?
They have no way to stop it or don't commit anything to stop it. He got the call so that he couldn't do the chrono.
Oh, and no
I guess
bash.
Just no bash means that he's going to be able to make it out.
Did he really got the call on Void there?
I didn't see.
Do we got an instant
it
replay?
It looked like force call stopped him from being able to chrono.
I didn't think he hit him in the call, but...
It doesn't matter, I guess.
Oh, Axe with no buyback? You don't think it matters?
I mean... Whatever.
I don't know. I mean, you gotta play and forget about it. You can't get tilted, but...
There we go.
I guess they had no Aegis. The Aegis was about to expire too, but...
Bot is just running around the map.
I guess it was just call and Shadow Demon was too far. But I definitely need some, like, I have only two disables, right? Void Chrono and Shadow Demon Disruption.
Yeah.
I think it's a little bit of a problem for them, so maybe they need some.
The poison stun on Dazzle. That'll stop your TP.
Yeah, that's nice.
But you're right, I mean, no hard committed lockdown except for if Jerix happens to be around. He has been, to his credit for the most part.
Nope. It's the kind of game we were expecting last game with the AM and Naga.
Yeah, right? But this one definitely going to be going the extra mile here as we get just past the 50-minute mark in game number 3. Winner to face Wings in the grand final.
He's getting close to a chaotic fight where people going to buy back and die 10 to 15 times and some team going to win. Yeah.
Always fun to cast.
Some
gets
team
so
gonna
crazy.
Alright, I believe that.
One team will win, one team will lose.
Whoever wants it more, guys.
Oh, yeah. Let's skip Bayless method. This team just wanted it more.
What? Sitting back? Both teams on their side of the map.
Kappa.
It's hard to gauge, like, who is pressured more so to kind of make a move. I mean, they're both just kind of in a neutral position when they both have their own equal farm. And a lot of them are getting ready to hit critical mass here.
Yes. I don't think there's pressure on either team is the thing. It's just there's pressure not to mess up the teamfight, but there's not pressure to win the game now.
Yeah, having good wards, looking for openings, trying to manipulate or take advantage of your opponent's movement.
You want the map, and you saw Timbersaw a minute ago buying a gem for the team, and...
Yeah, they both have gems.
Okay.
Two gems on Dire.
OG have something up their sleeve here.
I thought they already had a gem when you bought the gem. I was kind of curious about that, but...
Timbersaw still can change two items. Like, he can sell pipe, get something, like Hex maybe, and then he can also change Bloodstone for Dagon 5.
Bots to Moonshard. Yeah, there's plenty of
room. Moonshard, yeah. Chomp, chomp, chomp.
His tower hitting's not the best. Might as well hit it even more.
He has one of the scariest looking weapons.
Yeah, you think it'd do something. If it was Dota 1, the world tree, slice it down.
OG's plan now, they smoked up, and now they're just parked in this side shop here in hopes that maybe someone from Liquid might make an approach to the bottom lane.
Whoa.
There it is. It's Kuro. Oh, it's is happening. That move? Yes, it is. Ice Blast. We'll catch Fada on the way in. That's a big connection. Can they? Are they going to go right for the Fada Timber? Moon says yes. Pulls it back. And he gets out and away from the Chrono before Mind Control can catch it with Fada very low. Will end up going down. 80 seconds. No buyback for him. And now they're going to be looking to go for Mind Control here. Time walks back away. But OG say they want to keep their eyes on the prize. They keep moving forward. But Tumble Man's running out along with Kuro. They catch up Jerix. They'll get him. Double kill for No Tail. And they want more. Moving in. Kuro early self shallow grave. Not going to stop the dunk coming out from Miracle. And they'll get that one too. Three quickly strung together here for OG.
Oh,
they'll get
buyback.
The tier two. And buybacks are already going to begin to trickle out here from Liquid if they want to defend.
Just came off cooldown or just had the money for it, I guess. Maybe it's 5 gold short or something.
And they're fine with still just pushing with No Tail's illusions.
They have buybacks put on every hero. Yep.
And meta will wear off soon, so OG need to be careful about not overextending here.
No Chrono though. And
Mind Control got so unlucky, it was like microsecond where he was so fast in reaction when he saw Batrider was a Timber. But
or Moon was that good. Not unlucky, he just happened to get that quick reacting, that quick NA reaction of the Force Staff, you know?
Indeed.
Force Staff was super fast.
Scotty on Terrorblade, he's pretty strong.
Only got the one buyback Force though, and now they'll have to reset a bit. Satanic. Great item as long as he doesn't get under the ice blast.
Hey, oh, that's one thing.
Just avoid that and you'll definitely be able to make it work. And yeah, it was unfortunate because it looked like the ice blast was going to be just for Kuro, but then Fata, of course, ran right in, got clipped by it, and at that point they were able to kind of hog tie him up and finish him off.
It's a big deal too because that's Octarine and the reactive armor HP regen. He can get up to like a good 50 to 100 HP regen depending on how much damage he's doing per second.
Jump in, ice blast, could it be on Fata? Yeah, it will on both of them. Can they get the follow up? It's again another lasso, another pullback. Chrono will connect this time for Mind Control to slow them down, but is it going to be enough to save them? It does not look like it here. Fata will be going down, out without a buyback. Quick buyback will be there for Kuro. Mind Control looking to go in and pick up the pieces here. Ooh. Can't get crit, he stomps him down. And that's two out on the sidelines without a buyback. But Tumbleman, Valiant jumps in, pops the Satanic, gets the grave. He is just one man, and he's caught between three, caught between four. He goes down, does get Miracle on the back end there, but it might be too little, too late. Double kill for No Tail. And without any buybacks, OG begin their first huge siege into the base.
We're going straight for the throne if they really want this.
Wonderful setup there. Two times straight, yep. OG leading in Ice Blast, call connection onto Fada and take him out.
Yeah. And neither time was he the target for the Ice Blast as well, which is where it's like, wow. This is a bit unlucky, but OG come out in the clutch.
Just like that.
The mighty Dark Army of the Terrorblade cleaning out the Tier 4s here. And
TB
Liquid
got fat enough to pull that kill over team.
And that's it! With that, OG are going to be facing off against Wings in the grand final. A hell of a series by Liquid. They've made a run through the lower bracket to try to make it back here, but their journey ends now in third place in the Summit 5.
Some
great Dota.
That was a great game three. Very tactical game three there, very back and forth. It felt like a pretty passive period, but both teams kind of given that respect to each other, knowing that one sour, one bad fight, and you know, you were talking about a lot of